I look at the situation that you find in Lampard in at the minute, and Arteta's had it as well, where they've had a bit of a tough start, tough spells. The problem that, and people need to understand is that they've gone straight into a huge role, a huge job. So they've got nothing to fall back on. So if it starts having a tough period and things aren't going well, they're learning on the job. They're still learning their trade. They're young managers. So when you have a tough period as a manager, you can't go off your experience. You have to get through it as a new manager, and you have to find out ways to get through certain situations. If all of a sudden Lampard now is having a bit of a tough spell and they get rid of him, then he's not learning how to get through that spell as a Chelsea manager, and that's why you've got to stick with the project.
Sure, but I mean, this is not a criticism of them. They've been offered the job and they've taken the job, and you would take the job, right? But it's still, and I was saying this yesterday, it seems so strange to me, specifically with, you know, Arteta, who'd never managed a football match, that you sit at the interview and you go, have you ever done this before? I'm just looking at your CV, Mikel. It says you've managed one game when Pep was off. Oh, well, that won't be a problem. But like, these clubs are so big. Why are they going? I mean, I know they've got connections with the club. I find that really odd. It doesn't mean they won't work out.
No, because they would have looked at his interview. They would have looked at sort of who he's been working with in Guardiola. They would have looked at, you know, what he would have come in and said, his philosophy of how he wanted to change things and how he wanted to do things. But not being a manager is, you know, when you're a coach and you're the assistant, the pressure's never on you.
Sure.
You never have to stand up. You never have to come out and face the music if it's not going well. So he's having to learn that on the job. So he needs to be given time to ride through certain situations when it's not going well. And that's why this is a cutthroat industry. It's very easy just to say, let's get rid of him. He's not working. He's lost four or five on the bounce. It's not going well, when everyone's quick to jump on it. But give the guys time to implement their style, give them the time to go through that experience. Otherwise, there's no point in ever trying to get an inexperienced manager in.
Ali, but why would you get an inexperienced manager? I agree they need time, because you've got to give anyone time, but I don't understand why you wouldn't pick someone who'd done it before. Like, Carragher was really interesting on Monday Night Football. He was like, I'd love to be the Liverpool manager. I don't want to spend 7 years at Mainz. You know, he said, I don't want Gerrard to get the Liverpool job until he's done 10 years. So he's got that experience. Don't you think it's weird?
Yeah, it's not weird, because they have a vision of where they see the club. The manager's obviously come in and gave a great interview and give, you know, his side of how he expects it. If you're never given the opportunity to go in and have a chance, then you're never going to really be shown. You're never going to have the, you know, where's Arteta going to go? If he goes to, say, you know, I don't know,
Bournemouth
in the Championship, it might never work. So you might never see his potential.
Exactly.
But it might work in a certain style and a certain way of doing things at Arsenal Football Club, because he has a certain way of doing things.
If you don't have experience, you can't fall back on it going, I remember the last time I had to deal with this player.
How do you get experience?
Well, you don't get it at one of the biggest ones in the world. You know, I'm on the biggest sports radio station in the world now. I cut my teeth at Radio Cambridge. I didn't just walk in here and say, I've never done a radio show. Can I be here?